I got the party going up. A champ with the crown, yeah. I'm a winning player. Hey, so shake it like you don't care. I shake it up everywhere. And I can bake cakes by the pound. Blow the whistle because I love this.
The NFL on EA Sports has come to the Twin Cities at U.S. Bank Stadium in downtown Minneapolis. The scene a short time ago, this crowd decked out in purple, and they were in full roar as their guys burst out of the locker room. We're ready for football, folks, as the Vikings get set to do battle with the Tennessee Titans. Now K.J. Osborne. As this drive will start at the 25-yard line.
At their own 25-yard line.
They go play action here on first down. Looking for Jefferson, but this is intercepted. Picked up by the USC man, Adoree Jackson. And he will take this one home. It's a touchdown.
It goes without saying, but I'm going to say it anyway. That's a ball he would like to have back, and it lands right in the lap of the defender from there. He doesn't have very far to go before he gets to the end zone, and he got there in a hurry.
Gostkowski the extra point, and it's now a 7-0 game. So they throw the pick six. They'll get another shot at it now as this one's in the air. Here's Osborne. It's a pretty good return here as he'll get this up to the 29.
The Vikings take over first and
the Vikings now to start their next drive. Back to it after the pick six. Cousin sliding out of the pocket. His throw incomplete. He was trying to find Justin Jefferson there. And that'll bring up second down.
Justin Jefferson incomplete. It leads to second and 10.
Throwing is Cousins. And this one incomplete. Too much contact to hold on to that one, and it's third down.
And that's one of those plays where it's hard to keep two eyes on the football when you know the contact's coming, let alone getting two hands around it, hugging it to your body, and absorbing the hit, even for those big tight ends who you would think could absorb that contact.
And pass the 40 before he's out of bounds. Cousins in step with Jefferson that time. First down, Vikings. The first carry now for Dalvin Cook. And he's got this to the 30 before being taken down. That one 28 yards on the ground.
That outside handoff to the left, that play has to warm the heart of an offensive line coach because they controlled the left side where they were supposed to. They didn't allow anything to leak from the backside on the right side of the offensive line either.
And he will score. Touchdown, Vikings. Justin Jefferson, 30 yards. And the Vikings are an extra point away from tying this thing up. It's up and good. So these teams match touchdowns here in the first quarter, and we're tied 7-7. Seven now as they kick it away. And this carries into the end zone. And they'll get him down right around the 25, actually the 26 officially, so a net gain of one there.
At their own 26-yard line.
Tannehill and the Titans come up now first and 10 at their own 26. Off the play fake, he'll set up to throw it. He'll buy some time right, and now he's going to use his legs. And he'll be taken down, but not before they work it across midfield.
The tackle made.
Big yardage there on the scramble. It gets him a first down.
Now, those are the ones that hurt defensively. You do everything right. Excellent pressure, good coverage downfield, and then he slips out the back door and turns it into a nice game.
Here's a throw that's taken in out of the backfield. 20. And they'll have it in the red zone before he crosses over out of bounds. Boy, a pair of big plays here. This one going for 29. So from inside the 20, here's first and 10 at the 18. On the ground, this is Derrick Henry. And this time they were ready for him as they'll stop him right at the line of scrimmage.
Shamar Stephen
there on the tackle.
Gain on the play. Brings up second and 10 at the 18-yard line.
Looking to throw on second down. Tannehill escaping the pressure right. Tannehill able to take off and pick up the first as well.
Containing him is becoming a big problem. We've already seen this once earlier in this drive.
Yeah, and so now two times this has happened. Do you adjust something?
Yeah, I think you do. I think you have something about your rush lanes. Try not to either.
That'll be caught by Brown. Touchdown, Tennessee.
A.J. Brown.
8 yards on the touchdown pass, and the Titans have taken the lead. Well, that's about as quick of a passing touchdown as you'll ever see right there.
Everyone has a section in their playbook called the quick game. That was a super quick game. Out of the hands of the thrower, bam, right to the receiver, successfully for a touchdown.
How in-depth is that quick game part of the playbook?
It's pretty in-depth because people want the ball in the hands of the quarterback into the playmaker's hands downfield as fast as possible. There are a lot of plays, a lot of options involved with that.
The Minnesota offense about ready to get this next drive underway. And that last touchdown drive they had very balanced. How key is that balance?
It's huge because most of the time when we talk about balance is run, pass, almost 50-50. But most of the times when you talk to offensive coaches, they say balance is we do what we want when we want to. And that means that they're ahead of the defense, keeping them on their heels.
Yeah, they imposed their will on that last drive. Now on second and 13, Cousins. And a diving grab. I think he got that. Yes. Only 3 yards on the catch. It's third down.
Maximum effort, partner. Minimal gain.
Yeah, minimal gain. Looked good, though. On third down, Cousins. Got an open man finding Jefferson. And they nearly get this all the way to midfield. Mark him down at the 49. Through one corner, 14-7, our score.
First and 10 at the 49-yard line.
A first down throw for Cousins. This will be incomplete. Physical play on the football there, and it's second down.
Incomplete.
And I think they'd be well served to take that type of a physical approach against him the rest of the game. He's had his way so far, but on that last one, that worked quite well for the defense.
On second down, Cousins again. Open here, Adam Thielen. And he's going to have another first down as the tackle's made at the Titans 33. He goes for 18 there as the drive will continue. Cousins on first down. Blitz coming and down he goes. So second and long and got to be careful not to fall out of field goal range.
38-yard line.
Another try after the first down sack. Cousins. This one brought in by Jefferson. And he'll cross over out of bounds right at the 25. A good pickup there, 13 yards as they get closer for third down. Cousins on third and 2. Complete, Jefferson the target. And he will have the Vikings first down, and he's going to have it by plenty. Able to get 8 yards there on third and 2. Back-to-back receptions for him, and it's another first down.
First and 10 at the 18-yard line.
From the red zone now, Cousins. This throw caught right around the 6. And the Vikings are going to have a first and goal as the
team down to that point. His legs that finished the deal. Give him credit for making it happen.
And that is one, no doubt, that may come back to haunt them because the PAT tied it. They didn't need to go for two.
I keep searching for an explanation. I know it's quick right here. I think I can search for the next year and not come up with anything that absolutely works. Kick the point, man. Kick the point. I don't get it.
At their own 25-yard line.
The Titans offense set to begin the drive, and they're hoping to redo their efforts in the last drive when they got into the end zone.
And just think of what it's like now on the sideline, because when you score a touchdown, you have to go up and look at the tablet and see what you did on the last drive. When you score points, it's a whole lot better view than when you're trying to figure out how to fix things there.
And incomplete as he was knocked as he threw it, and it took the ball off course. And he is going to be stopped cold behind the line of scrimmage. 2 yards the loss, and now third and 12.
And that's what I'd like to see out of this defense, a little fire, a little toughness. It hasn't been the best first half for them, but they did do a nice job there, forcing a loss on that play.
Flushed out right. He's going to look downfield for Henry. Counting down toward halftime on EA Sports. Coming up at halftime in a little less than 2 minutes, we'll send you to Orlando where Jonathan Coachman is standing by. He'll have highlights and analysis of this first half. He can run for it, and he will. The coverage may be too good that time as he breaks away for 19 with his legs and a first down.
Not sure I agreed with the decision to go for it, but I definitely agreed with his decision to run it. He picked up that big first down. I think he let his head coach off the hook.
That's what I was just going to say. If there's anybody more happy than the quarterback picking it up, it's the coach that saw him pick it up. And oh, so close as he takes it all the way to the 2 yard line.
First and goal.
The Vikings going to signal for the first of their timeouts as they'll stop it with just over a minute to go before halftime. It looks like a jumbo set with three tight ends here for first and goal. Trying to punch it in with Henry. And they'll bring him down after just a short pickup. Only a yard that time, second and goal.
He gets it halfway there with that run. I think you play up tempo, get right back on the line of scrimmage, and hammer at him again.
Second down and goal. Tannehill. And into the end zone for a Tennessee touchdown.
Touchdown, Tennessee.
Ryan Tannehill taking it in. And the Titans are able to extend their lead.
And that lead is now 7 with a chance to go to 8 or more if they want to get crazy here, which we don't expect. But I just know the way the game's being played with the analytics, there's going to be a lot more of going for 2 in a lot of situations, isn't there?
Yeah, there's going to be. And I think their focus here, they don't want to give up anything going into the lockers on the other end. Just a little bit of time left on the clock.
Yeah, they don't want to do anything to erase the good feeling they have right now by getting this late score in the half.
Here are the Vikings now to start their next drive. And what do you think goes on here in this situation? If you got the football, you're trailing, you're back in your own territory with just a little time, do you try something?
You're thinking about jump-starting your team, right? You just mentioned they're down, they're trying to get back into the game. But you got to figure, if something goes wrong, you may have put yourself in a spot where you may not be able to come back in the second half. Managing risk, this is a big decision here.
That's complete to the receiver, Thielen. The Vikings going to use their third and final timeout as the clock will stop with 20 seconds to go in the first half. little bit of a stiffer challenge now. First and 15 following the delay of gain. Cousins now. Throw left side, taken in by Jefferson. And he'll be out of bounds just inside the 25-yard line.
Out of bounds at the 24-yard line. A 9-yard pickup. It's second and 6.
Throwing again on second down. Cousins. And he's got his man on the out route. And he's out of bounds. Almost gets to the 10. 11 yards there. First down. They'll throw again. Cousins. Toward the end zone, but that's going to wind up incomplete.
Incomplete on the throwaway. It's now second and 10.
So on second down, the field goal unit is on here as they try to get 3 before half. And Bailey able to knock it through. So yes, they'll still be down going into intermission, but the deficit is now made even smaller, very manageable.
Yeah, and if nothing haywire happens here in this last couple of precious seconds, they will go into the locker room with a nice bounce in their step, having gotten a little bit closer on the scoreboard.
And he'll be stopped right around where he would have been had he gone down to a knee, maybe a yard shy of there at the 24. So time perhaps for one final kneel down before they take this lead to the locker room. All that remains is to snap this once, and that'll do it for the first half of play. So we've hit intermission. It's halftime. This is the NFL, and it's a presentation of EA Sports. All right, Coach, thank you, and we welcome everyone back for quarter number 3. The Titans hold the lead, and they'll get the football first as the third quarter gets underway. Fields it in the middle of the end zone. And he'll be stopped right around where he would have been had he gone down to a knee, maybe a yard shy of there at the 24.
At their own 24-yard line.
The Titans offense set to begin the drive. And both of these defenses have been stifling these last few drives offensively. Just not able to get anything going. So what needs to change?
And a lot of the guys will go back and review, so to speak, because everyone has someone assigned to. How did each play work? Okay, what did we use that kind of worked for us during this game? Try and get back some of those plays, as well as the possibility of showing something you haven't shown already in this game and trying to change things up.
We'll see if they take the advice of Mr. Davis. That throw right sideline here is complete. And he'll go out of bounds, it appears, right at the 45. He was out there waving his arms. And when you got a quarterback out of the pocket looking for any help, I guess waving the arms is helpful.
It certainly is, because you got to get his attention, because now you're in scramble drill. So everyone's adjusting their routes, finding open space, and he found the right spot for the completion.
That one, a first down pickup of 8.
Second and 2 is prime. A little bit of a gamble, isn't it? Open up the playbook, go play action, toss that bad boy deep. But in this situation, go ahead and give it to your back. Let him pick up a first down. Keep the sticks moving.
That one a broken play, but it ends up being a good play. The scramble goes for 20.
Partner, as a quarterback, sometimes you just got to know when the clock has gone off in your head, it's time to go. Tuck it and get all you can.
A first down carry for Henry. Anthony Harris on the tackle. In the first half, he was held in check on the ground, but despite that lack of production, they still have the lead.
Yeah, and they've got to feel fortunate about that. If they could actually get production from their lead horse, that would help open up this offense and widen this margin, too.
The last run got 3. Now here's 2nd and 7. They'll try the air now with Tannehill. Quick slant to Brown. And into the end zone for a Tennessee touchdown.